गुड मॉर्निंग एवरीवन, दिस इज योर प्रोफेसर अजय छाबड़ा. लेट मी शो यू टुडे हाउ टू डू गूगल एडवर्ड्स कीवर्ड एनालिसिस. ओके, सो फॉर स्टार्टिंग ए कीवर्ड एनालिसिस देर आर कपल ऑफ थिंग्स विच यू हैव टू कीप इन माइंड एज आई डिस्कस इन द क्लास ऑल्सो दैट फॉर डूइंग ए प्रॉपर कीवर्ड एनालिसिस देर आर कपल ऑफ थिंग्स विच यू हैव टू कीप इन माइंड. ओके, सो यू हैव टू ऑलवेज कीप इन टू कंसिडरेशन मल्टीपल पैरामीटर्स विद रिगार्ड्स टू कीवर्ड रिसर्च एंड दीज पैरामीटर्स आर समथिंग लाइक यू कैन ऑलवेज लुक एट मल्टीपल पैरामीटर्स लाइक सपोज यू टेक कार इंश्योरेंस एज की फ्रेज. ओके, नाउ एट्रीब्यूट्स ऑफ ए कार इंश्योरेंस देर कैन बी नंबर ऑफ कीवर्ड्स अराउंड दैट समथिंग लाइक कॉम्प्रिहेंसिव कार इंश्योरेंस, थर्ड पार्टी कार इंश्योरेंस. ओके, now your sales team or people in your business development they can help you give lot of input and insights about keywords. Basically same way you should talk to your vendors know how they have found you, so they would give you great insights about how they found you as a company or as a product, so they can give you insights about how to do better keyword research. Same way you have your customers who can give you insights about how they are finding you or how they found you on internet or in search engines. So those customers, your suppliers, your vendors, your sales team, they can give you a lot of inputs about keywords which you need to target for any prospective new customer basically. Now this is called now we will talk about other aspects like attributes of keywords which we can take into consideration. Okay, then you should also include brand keywords. Suppose you are Echo General Insurance or Tata AIG Car Insurance. So because people who are aware of your brand and they are searching with your brand name in the keyword phrase, so you should always have ad groups and ad campaigns running around brand keywords, because that's how you can organically will come on top. And as well as even if somebody is searching for sponsored, you should come on top. The advantage of branded keywords are that they can give you the best of the kind of returns and at a very very lower CPC basically. Then you could always use keywords combinations like top, best in front of prefix to your primary phrase which you are doing keyword research on. Then you can always look at the keywords which are related to price and offer basically. Now price means cheapest car insurance, economical car insurance, affordable car insurance starting at 50% price, car insurance as low as 2000 rupees. Okay, then there are action keywords basically. These are like buy car insurance, sell car insurance, price of car insurance, quotation of car insurance, comparison of car insurance prices basically. Right, so these are another set of dimensions with respect to finding new keywords which you can include in your campaign. Then there are competition keywords basically. Since you are a company, there are other companies in the market who have their brand keyword searches happening. So Google AdWords allows you to keep all the keywords with the competition brand name as your keywords. It is allowed, but the restriction is that you cannot use any brand name, third party brand name in your text ad. So make sure that whenever you are drafting your text ads, you should not use anybody else's trademark or brand name, which is not allowed in the text ads. However, you can use create a competition ad group and include all your competition brands as your keywords basically, so that if somebody is searching for Tata AIG and you are Echo Car Insurance, your ad will show up basically. So this is the best part about keyword like research. Now these are some of the things which if you apply, you can be mastering the skill of keyword analysis. Now let's go back to the tool and which I wanted to show you. Let me just share the tool with you. Now we are on Google right now. Okay, now in Google we have to simply go and type Google Ads. So make sure that you have already logged in to the Gmail account from which the your ad Google ad account is already linked basically. So simply log on to, you will see this first result, Google Ads India, sign into Google Ads, click on that. So you will reach that Google Ads sign in window. On top, if you have not created an account, you can create a new account, or if you are already created an account, you can click sign in. When you click sign in, it will by default take you to that particular Gmail ad account which is linked to your Gmail ID. Now I have already entered my Google Ads account. Now if you look at the broader architecture of this account, on top you will see that there is a search icon, there is reports icon, there are some pre-built reports, and there are custom reports which you can build. Then there is something called tools and settings. Now these are the, this is the most important third icon on top, navigation, tools and settings, which is mostly used. Then you can refresh the settings, you can seek help in case you are stuck on any topic. Then you have notifications. These notifications are nothing but these are AI algorithm recommendations which Google Ads keep on giving to this account with respect to any campaign you have made. Then you see the A, which is the email ID which I have logged in. So I have logged in into my email account, Professor Ajay Chhabra, profajaychhabra@gmail.com. So that's where it shows. Now if you wish to change and you log on to other ad account, you can change the Gmail ID with this help basically. Now we are on overview window right now. If you look at this, this is the overview window. What it gives you is a overview of number of clicks, number of impressions, number of average CPC, amount of average CPC, and cost you have spent so far. Since it's a new account, I haven't done any campaign. Now let me show you example of another account where I have done some campaigns. So this data will be automatically populated. Let's switch over to another one. Let it load. Now in this, let's say this is the time frame window. You click let it load because this is a heavy application, so it takes some time to load in browser. So let us just click on this time frame, and from here the time frame window allows you to go to today, yesterday, this week, last 7 days, last week, last 14 days, this month, last 30 days, last month, and all time. Let me just click on all time data. So when I select all time, it will set the time frame to the maximum period possible when I started this ad account and when I started working on that. So it will like kind of refresh in some time and show you the data basically. Just let me see. Now let me just switch over. Let me see. We are on. Let me go to another account to show you data. Okay, now in this particular account which I have logged in, I can see some data like CTR, clicks, average CPC, and cost which we have spent in this particular account. So that's an overview window, and you can change these matrices. Suppose instead of CTR you want to see impression, you can do this way. If you want to see clicks, you want to see the cost. So all those factors you can change. Suppose I want to see that average CPC basically here. So you can see average CPC, impressions, CTR, clicks, whatever primary matrices which you want to track. Now coming back to the main account which we were working upon, or maybe we can continue working on this one also, that is not a challenge. Now in this, simply you have to there are certain notifications which keep on coming. You can remove all of them, notifications. Now in this, suppose I go to the tools and settings tab. In the tools and settings tabs, to start keyword analysis, I have to go to the planning tab. I click on that. You see performance planner, keyword planner, reach planner, ad preview and diagnostics, and then app advertising hub. So let's click on keyword planner first. So the moment I click on keyword planner, I go to a particular screen where I can start my keyword analysis. So now it gives you two options to start. Number one, discover new keywords and get search volume and forecast basically. Now what we are going to do right now, we'll click on the first one, which is discover new keyword. Now when you click on discover new keywords, so it gives you an option of search bar, okay, wherein you can type a search phrase. Let's say electric charger manufacturer or manufacturing basically. Okay, electric charger manufacturing. By default the geography is set to India and the language is set to English. I can add any more number of keywords. If I want, I can change the geography by clicking on that India. Suppose I don't want India, I can look at USA. So by default, it will give me options of United States as a country. I can target them. It will change the map. Let's say by default, I want to go back to India only. So let me just click on that. You can select a particular city. Suppose you want to select Pune only. Okay. Now let us find out how many searches are happening on electric vehicle charging manufacturing companies in Pune. So let's save that. Okay. Now in this, in case you are already having a website, you can put the website URL over here and Google will give you directions in terms of, it will pull out the best keywords from your website also basically. Okay. So two options are there on top, start with a keyword or start with a website basically. It gives you both the options basically, but we are starting with a keyword. So let's click on get results, the button down below. The moment you click on this button, so it will start processing to get the keywords and it will show you this particular window. Now you see this screen, you get the couple of things. Now if we start, now what we search for, we search for electric charger manufacturing. Okay, now it has given you EV charger manufacturing keywords 10 to 100, EV charging keywords. So it is giving you a lot of keywords like this, and we can click the let me just give you, explain you the architecture of what we get as a search result. And if you look at the top basically, first on the top left it shows you electric charger manufacturing, which is the keyword phrase which we searched. Then it shows you geography. Okay, now let me, in if you want to change the geography again, you can come back here. Let's say I want to put India. I take India as a country and then see it, does it affect. So you now you see that the keyword range and the average searches volume has already changed basically. Okay, it has become 100 to 1000 basically. Now you can change the language if you wish. There are multiple languages Google allows. You can use any one of the language. Then this is the time frame it gives you. The by default Google keyword planner gives you search results for the last 1 year. So March 2022 to February 2023. Now if you wish, you can select a particular date range. You can go to last month for better accuracy of data. I personally recommend and use last month data, because last month will give you definitely trends basically, because otherwise it will average out for 12 months. So now last let's say for last 5-6 months, if there were no searches on a particular keyword, the average will be less. But if you look at the last month volume, it will be almost accurate or contemporary basically. Now there are other keywords which are coming by default from Google, which is electric charger manufacturing power tools, electric battery manufacturing, electric cable manufacturing. Now if you feel that some of the keywords are important for your search point of view, you should include, let's say electric charger is important, so I refine my results basically, right? Then let's say vehicle charger, this might be important, I refine my results basically. Okay, so all those keywords keep on getting added in the my search result below. Then vehicle charging system, that might be important for me, I include that also. Okay, now so then charger manufacturing is generic, so we wouldn't want to take that. Volt charger, electric charging system, so okay, so we just stick to this one. Now if you see the headers which you get, you can exclude certain keywords also. There is option of excluding. Now right now it is showing us 1327 keywords, okay, based on the phrases we have taken. Now first column head is keyword by relevance, so the popular keywords come on top. You can click on this one and refresh, and the data like ascending descending order you can check. Then it's the second column is average monthly search volume, so this is called MSV. Then the third is 3 month change, it shows you percentage of how this keyword has been performing for the last 3 months. Then it also shows you a ratio of year on year change for that particular keyword. It also shows you competition index as a next column. Earlier it used to be giving competition index in the range of 1 to 100. Now they have scaled it down to low, medium, high. So if the competition index is high on a particular keyword, what it means is that there is a probability of that the other company to use the other brand who's your competition brand who's running the same campaign, there is a probability that he's using that particular keyword. So keywords with high competition index are mandatory to be taken for any campaign which you are planning basically. Then ad impression share, then it also gives you top of the page bid price range. So it give you price range that what should be the bid price in case you want to get top of the page basically. Okay, so high range and low range it gives you. So this is the kind of data you get. Now once you have done that keyword research, you found out relevant, you can select and deselect keywords here, or you could download the entire thing. When you select on the keyword by relevance checkbox, it's by default whatever number of keywords you are available for display in your window, let's say right now it is 100, it will select those 100. But if you wish to select all, there is a button which says select all keywords. So I click on that. Now by default all the keywords are selected. Now the thing would be that you can just download it. Okay, there is a download button. Now there is a screen resolution issue on my iPad, because of which I am not able to see this download button, which is normally on the right top basically. Okay, so on the right top you will see a download button. Simply you click on that and you can run the download this keyword report in either CSV format, comma separated value, or in the you can save this file to Google Drive basically. So you can save these keywords to Google Drive. Then there are other options which we should see. There is a forecasting window. You can see a forecast for a particular keyword. Then there are if you save certain keywords, they will show up here. If you take some keywords in negative, they will show up over here basically. So this is how we do keyword analysis, and it's a very, very important fundamental tool from Google. And I believe that based on the insights earlier shared, that how to plan a keyword research along with this knowledge of Google Keyword Planner tool, you can easily do great keyword planning. So best of luck for your keyword research. And it's your Professor Ajay Chhabra. Thank you so much.